Welcome back, children, for the segment one today. That will be the definition of accounting and its features. So I'm starting with the definition of accounting by one of the very famous writers, Smith and Ashburn. I'm having it on my BB board written. You can have a glance of this definition very carefully so that you understand each and every element from this particular definition. Okay, so here we go. Accounting is the science of recording and classifying business transactions. What is accounting? It is a science, it is a systematic study of what? Of recording and classifying business transactions. First, you have to record, you have to write, and also you have to classify. It means grouping of similar kind of events at one place. So these are the two things which are required in accounting. Accounting is the science of recording and classifying what? Business transactions. The transactions means the events which are relating to business. And events primarily of what kind of character? Of financial character. Financial character means monetary character. And the art of making significant summaries, analysis and interpretation. It is also an art. It is also an art which has the process of making significant summaries, that we have to take out the gist, the summary from a particular record, and we have to analyze it, and then we have to interpret the results of these transactions and events, and communicating the results to the persons who must make the decisions or form judgments. So this is the definition of accounting in a very technical wording that you have to understand and learn. I'm repeating the whole definition once more, then we'll move on to the characteristics based on this definition. Accounting is the science of recording and classifying business transactions and events primarily of a financial character, and the art of making significant summaries, analysis and interpretations of these transactions and events, and communicating the results to the persons who must make decisions or form judgments. So this is a technical definition that we have taken up as a base for accounting definition. We will be doing the explanation of this particular definition step by step so that you can understand each element. Okay, so here we go with the first feature based on this definition, that is, accounting is art as well as science. Now, what do we consider as science first? Science is anything which is studied in a systematic manner, which has a cause and effect relationship, which is not only based on daydreaming, it is based on experimentation, the facts. So accounting information is not based on dreaming concept. It is not a fictional concept which you are dreaming in the storyline and then you are drawing it. No, there has to be some fact, some evidence, some proof, and on the basis of which you will write anything in accounting books. Suppose if you have purchased a commodity for 50,000 rupees, who will believe you that you have purchased unless and until you don't have the bill? You have to show the bill that this purchase I made from such and such shopkeeper, and for this I have paid this 50,000 rupees. So unless and until you're not having the bill, nobody is going to believe that you have purchased a commodity. So in accounting, we follow that there should be facts, and the record shall not be created merely on intuition method. It has to be a systematic manner which should be based on facts and truths. So that's why accounting is a science. Now, what does accounting, what makes accounting as an art? See, as every painter has his own style of painting. If I say draw a scenery, and every painter will be having his own style of painting, and he will draw his own kind of scenery. Similarly, every accountant has his own way of presenting accounts, has his own way of drafting accounts. So he will use his own skills and capacity and capability in drafting the accounts. So that's why accounting is an art, which requires the specialized effort and creativity by an accountant for its presentation. Okay, so that's why accounting is an art as well as science. Now moving on to the second element of the definition, that is recording of financial transactions. In accounting, we can record only and only financial transactions. We cannot record any transaction which cannot be measured in terms of money. For example, if I have a very good reputation in the market, I cannot record it. If I have very good relations with my laborers, relations with my employees, I cannot record it. If only and only anything can be measured in terms of money, that can be recorded. For example, if I purchase a building for 5 lakh rupees, then the building's value can be calculated as rupees 5 lakh. I can record this transaction. If I attend a party, I cannot record this transaction because it cannot be calculated in terms of money. So only financial transactions can be recorded in accounting. That is the second feature. Now moving on to classification, classifying. As in your day-to-day life also, you cannot do every work in one register as far as fair work is concerned. How you divide it? You divide it as a register of business studies, a register of accountancy, a register of economics, a register of maths, and so on. Why do you do this classification? In order to make it easy for you as well as the teacher that how much portion has been covered in one subject. So it's easy to check, it's easy to revise, it's easy to locate. Similarly, in accounting also, the transactions are grouped and they are recorded in a particular group. For example, we have a purchase book. In that book, all the events relating to only purchases will be written. We have a sales book. Then all the events relating to sales will be written in the sales book. Are you getting my point? So one type of transactions will be written at one place. This act is called classification or classifying. Now moving on to summarization. Since there are thousands of events happening in the day-to-day business, so what we do, we have to make it into compact size so that we can easily understand. For example, while you get your report card, what happens? The entire year's work is being summarized, is being shown in a very compact size to your parents on the last day or on the result day of the class session. So what happens? Your parents will see the report card and at a glance they'll be able to understand that in unit 1 you did this, unit 2 you did this, term 1 you did this, and term 2 you have performed like this. So entire result is being shown on one page as a summarized result, so that anybody who is seeing your result is able to understand what is your academic performance in the entire year. Similarly, what we do, at the end of the year, we summarize the entire records in the form of profit and loss account and balance sheet, so that whosoever is willing to find the information about what we have done in the entire year will be able to understand it, that whether the firm has earned profit or whether the firm is suffering a loss or what has happened in the entire year. It is a kind of a report card which is to be presented to the taxation authorities, to the management, to everyone else who is requiring it, so that the performance of the firm can be analyzed and judged. It means summarization, putting the accounting information in a compact, small size so as to make it understandable. Now, interpretation of the results. After you get your summarized records, we have to find out the results, whether profit, whether loss, whether progress, whether the firm has declined in its performance. So this is called interpretation of the results. That is primarily done by the management people. They read the summaries, they find out that whether the firm has earned profit or loss. They form their judgments. And then communication of the results is also very important. There are so many people who are interested in accounting information. For example, the government is interested to know the accounting information of a particular business in order to calculate tax. The management requires the accounting information in order to formulate further programs, further policies, in order to expand the business, and so on, what so on. Employees also require. So there are so many people who are interested in accounting information. So what we are supposed to do? We have to communicate this accounting information to the various groups of the people. So these are the precise features of accounting, as we have already discussed in the definition. In the next video, we'll go with the objectives of accounting. Stay tuned.